Well, we are down to the final day of the Queensland election campaign as a stunning new poll reveals David Crisafulli is poised to become Queensland's next Premier, but only just. For more, let's bring in NDIS and Government Services Minister Bill Shorten in Ipswich and Opposition Leader Peter Dutton from the Sunshine Coast, also in Queensland. It's all about the Sunshine State today, isn't it, Bill? Good morning to you. After almost a decade in power, it seems Queensland will soon be LNP territory. Does that worry you ahead of a federal election?
Well, it'll be up to the people of Queensland. I'm here in Ipswich West with Wendy Bourne, who's seeking to win the seat back for Ipswich West. I think Stephen Miles has surprised people, running a very active campaign. I mean, he's focused on the issues which affect Queenslanders: housing, health, cheaper transport, and of course tackling youth crime. So we'll find out soon enough who's going to win, but Wendy Bourne is without a doubt the best candidate in Ipswich West.
Well, Peter, David Crisafulli has squandered a comfortable lead in this campaign. He's already losing support and he's not even Premier yet. Is he up to the job?
Morning, Sarah. Morning, Bill. Look, it's always going to be a tough race. The Labor Party's able to sandbag seats, but if you've got Bill Shorten out in Ipswich West, you know that Labor's in trouble. That should be a safe seat for them. But fact is that it's time for a change in Queensland, and law and order is out of control, and you've got a situation where people are sick of what the government's had. Stephen Miles has tried to abandon his entire period as Deputy Premier in this state, and I think people are ready for a change in Queensland, but it's always tight and people shouldn't take anything for granted.
Well, it's interesting. The cost of living has emerged as the main issue in this campaign, Bill, and Stephen Miles has given that a red-hot go. But this was basically mission impossible for him, wasn't it? Should Anastasia Palaszczuk have stepped down earlier?
Oh, listen, I think we're close enough to the election that we'll wait till Saturday night before we start working out what went well and what went badly. But your cost of living points are very solid. And I think that Stephen Miles' proposition for cheaper transport has gone down very well. And the $1,000 energy rebate on top of the $500 energy rebate that we've been supplying people. Yeah, I think Labor's talking about the issues that matter. I have been a bit surprised to see the issue of whether or not abortion should be criminalised emerge, though. It seems like someone in the LNP swallowed the Trump playbook, and we don't need that sort of division in this country, and women in Queensland should have access to safe health care.
Well, it's Robbie Katter who raised that and put it on the table and has effectively derailed the campaign in a way. News poll, though, is not the only place Stephen Miles is making gains right now. He has run an interesting campaign in the gym. And Peter Dutton, I wondered if this might be a strategy that you may employ in your campaign. Can you bench press 100 kilos?
Can I assure you that you won't be seeing any photos of me in gym wear? I'm at the Daniel Morcombe Walk this morning, which is the 20th anniversary. It's a wonderful foundation and people should jump online and donate to this amazing cause. But this is as close as I get. I learnt the lesson from Bill in 2019 just to be very careful of skin-tight clothing and what you're doing in front of the cameras.
Well, it's nice that you can support one another in such a meaningful way. They do fantastic work, the Morcombes.
Thanks, Pete.
I've been following them for a very long time, and we will have more on that a little later. A stunning poll on the eve of the Queensland election shows the vote is now much closer than anyone had predicted. Straight to today, Queensland reporter Andrea Crothers in Brisbane. Andrea, it's all coming down to the wire.
Yeah, Jane, it sure is. If those polls are anything to go by, it appears Labor has won the campaign, but the LNP still in line to win the election. The latest news poll in The Australian today shows on the two-party preferred basis, the LNP opposition leader David Crisafulli sitting at 52.5%. So that has come back slightly from 55% from a poll in mid-September. Interestingly, though, as well, the popularity rating of David Crisafulli has fallen. Stephen Miles now ahead as the preferred premier. There is just a day and a half or so to go until the polls close. We know that the LNP have at last released their costings, showing that they will have less debt than what Labor would. They say this will all come through public service reforms and making major cuts to private consultants, saving $6.8 billion. While Stephen Miles, he is doing a last-ditch campaign blitz. 36 seats in 36 hours is his aim, guys.
Welcome back to the show. The countdown to the Queensland election is on. Stephen Miles and David Crisafulli both in a final blitz to secure seats. Joining us to discuss today's headlines is ALP President Wayne Swan and Stella magazine seller Lamarck One. Nice to see you. Wayne, to you first of up, Miles looks like he's got your grubby fingerprints all over him. Has he
I think he's his own man, actually.
But do you know what I mean, Swanee? Have you been in his ear?
Look, I think his performance has been extraordinary. He's in front as the preferred premier. His focus on the cost of living has hit the mark. You know, the 50-cent fares, rego discounts. Mm. But also, you know, I wouldn't discount the role that abortion has played in this election, where David Crisafulli's party room is 90% in favour of criminalising abortion. So the cost of living relief has been really important. The emphasis on the cuts the LNP would do, like they did last time, all of that has struck a real nerve out there in the community. And Stephen himself has personally performed extraordinarily well.
Crisafulli said on our show about half an hour ago those campaign tactics were damaging to him and very effective. What did you think from the sidelines, Sarah, watching a Queensland election happen?
I must say that I have found that the fact that abortion seems to have been tabled as an issue in Australian politics to be really disappointing. And I think that is absolutely because of Robbie Katter has tabled that. And I think the LNP have shown a lack of leadership, in my view, unless it's been a deliberate strategy to dog whistle to people that also want to see Australia go backwards and a woman's right to choose to become an election issue. So I think that's been really disappointing. And for me, that obviously doesn't live in Queensland. To see that the election campaign has progressed in this way over the last few weeks has been quite concerning.
It makes them uneasy bedfellows, does it not, Robbie Katter and Stephen Miles? But Stephen Miles will still do a deal with him, right?
I don't think so. I don't think there's any deals here at all. The problem is the Americanisation of the conservative side of politics, who are going down the road we've seen in America, and it's infected the LNP in Queensland. As I said, 90% of their party room voted in favour of criminalising abortion not too long ago. And that's why it's an issue in the campaign. It's not just because it's been put there by the Labor Party. It's been put there by the Liberal Party.
All right, who wins it?
Oh, I think it's a really tight race. We've got a long way to go, but, you know, there's 24 hours.
Look, Swanee loves it. You just love election eve, don't you? Especially in Queensland.
I do, yeah.
See, he does have your grubby fingerprints all over him, Swanee.
I delete grubby.
That's a close to an admission I'm going to get.